Again, I am Kunna from Kunna's Horizon. I am here to tell you something about the numericals on current electricity part 2. Here I am going to discuss some problems, some numericals on certain formulas. So if you will go through this, I am sure that your doubts on the numerical problems will be cleared. So always remember to subscribe it. Subscribe the channel and give your comment in the comment box. View the videos from starting to ending without skipping. Then only you can gain knowledge. Your subscription will make the channel valuable and your comments will make the videos much more improvised for your gaining of the knowledge. So let us start the problem. Now I have written here one problem. See here, I is equal to Q by T and that is equal to N into E by T. In a particular television tube, a beam of electrons is emitted. The beam current is 80 microampere. How many electrons strike the screen of the TV every second? Also find the total charges striking the screen. So let us divide this one into two parts. The number one solution is, what is given here? The number first part is I is equal to given here 80 into 80 microampere. So this is equal to 80 into 10 to the power minus 6 ampere. So this is equal to 8 into 10 to the power minus 5 ampere. So this is the given here current. Time is equal to 1 second. So we will find out now the number of electrons. We know if the value of E is equal to 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. So now I have the formula I is equal to N into E by T. So T is equal to 1 second. So I is equal to, this implies I is equal to 80 into 10 to the power minus 6 is equal to N into 10 to the 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 by time is equal to 1. So N is equal to 80 into 10 to the power minus 6 by 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. This is equal to 5 into 10 to the power 14. 5 into 10 to the power 14. So this is the answer for the number of electrons striking the screen. Now for the second bit. This is for solution for the first bit. For the second bit, what I will tell you is that here we have the same formula. I is equal to Q by T. So Q is equal to, this implies Q is equal to I into T. So this is equal to, I is given here. What is the value of I? 8 into 10 to the power minus 5 ampere into time. Time is given here 2 minutes. So 2 minutes. This is equal to 8 into 10 to the power minus 5 into 2 into 60 seconds. So we will convert this one into seconds. 2 into 60. So this is equal to 9600 into 10 to the power minus 6. So this is equal to this much coulomb. This is equal to 9600 microcoulomb. So this is the answer. So you understood now. Next I will move to the next problem. So number 5. What is number 5? Number 5, with the same formula, number 5 is 10 to the power 20 electrons, 10 to the power 20 electrons each having charge of 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19, 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb, pass from a point A towards another point B. Another point B in 0.1 second. In 0.1 second, calculate the current in ampere. Calculate the current in ampere and give its direction. Now for solution, what is given here? That is 10 to the power minus 20 electrons. Number n is equal to 10 to the power solution. In solution, what is given here? N is equal to 10 to the power 20 electrons. 10 to the power 20 electrons. E is equal to 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. So I is equal to n into e by t. So time is given here 0.1 second. So n is equal to 10 to the power 20 into 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 by time. Time is equal to 0.1, this much ampere. So this is equal to 160 ampere. So this is equal to 1.6 into 10 by 10 to the power 2 by 1. So this is equal to 1.6 into 10 to the power 1 by 0.1. So this is equal to 16 into 10 to the power 2. 1.6 into 10 to the power 2. This is equal to 160 ampere. This is equal to 160 ampere. And the direction of current from point is from point B to A. Direction of the current is from point B to A. All of you remember that. Again I am telling you, 10 to the power 20 electrons each having charge of 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 pass from a point A towards another point B in 0.1 second. Calculate the current in ampere and give the direction. So what is given? N is equal to 10 to the power 20 electrons. Next, E is given 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. Time is given 0.1 second. So I is equal to N E by T. 10 to the power 20 into 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 by 0.1. So 1.6 is remaining constant here, same here, but 10 to the power 20 minus 19, because bases are same, power will be subtracted. 20 minus 19 is equal to 1, and that is equal to 0.1, 1.6 into 10 by 0.1. So that is equal to 1.6 into 10 to the power 2, 1. This one will be 1 by 10, and this 10 will go to the numerator, and that becomes 10 to the power 2. So this is equal to 160 ampere. So the next problem is number 6. Number 6, calculate the number of electrons. Number 6, calculate the number of electrons that flow per second to constitute a current of 1 ampere charge on an electron is electron is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. So solution here you have to calculate the number of electrons. That means N is to be calculated. Then that flow per second and to constitute or the flow per second, time is equal to 1 second. And current is equal to I is equal to 1 ampere. Charge on and E is equal to 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. So we have the formula I is equal to N E by T. So I is given here 1 ampere. This is equal to 1 ampere. That is equal to number of N is to be calculated, and E is given here 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 by time is given here 1. So time is given here 1. So this is equal to N is equal to 1 by 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. This is equal to N, 1 by 1.6 into 10 to the power 19. So the, when we calculate this one, this we will get 6.25 into 10 to the power 18 per second. So I think you have understood this type of problems. where we are calculating the number of electrons and or whether in or current or time using that formula. Again, I am repeating, calculate the number of electrons that flow per second to constitute a current of 1 ampere. Charge on an electron is this much. So here n has been asked, number of electrons. T is given per second, means 1 second. Current 1 ampere. E is equal to 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. So I is equal to n E by T. So when we will calculate this one, putting the formulas, I is equal to 1 ampere, n is equal to be calculated, and E is the number of electrical charge, 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 by time taken 1 second. So this is equal to n is equal to 1 by 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. This is equal to 6.25 into 10 to the power 18 per second. Electrons per second. So next one. The next problems are on another formulas. Now we will see about another formulas. What is that? That constitutes the Ohm's law. Ohm's law. V is equal to I R. V is equal to I R. And R is equal to rho L by R. L by A. So V is equal to I R. And R resistance means potential difference is equal to current multiplied by resistance. V by I is equal to constant is the Ohm's law. Next, resistance is equal to rho L by A. Resistance is directly proportional to length. Resistance is inversely proportional to area. So when we will combine those two, we will get the formula R is directly proportional to L by A, and therefore R is equal to resistivity rho by L by A. Rho is the proportionate constant, or what we take, and that is the rho is the resistivity of the current of the conductor. So rho is the resistivity of the conductor, which is taken as the proportionate constant, because rho is always constant for a certain material. So for a certain material or for a certain conductor, rho is always constant. So rho is a proportionate constant is taken here. So let us move for the problems. Now number one is a heater of resistance 50 ohm. A heater of resistance 50 ohm. Resistance 50 ohm is connected in 220 volt. Is connected in 220 volt. 220 volt. So how much current will this heater draw? How much current will this heater draw? So what is the question? And so see here, a heater of resistance solution. I told you, read the question carefully and then write what is given. Resistance is given how much? 50 ohm. And the potential difference is given is to a potential difference is 220 volt potential, and current has been asked. This is equal to resistance R, potential difference V, and current has been asked I. So we have I is V is equal to IR. V is equal to IR is the formula. So for current I, I is equal to V by R. I is equal to V by R. So what is V? V is known as the, what is V given here? That is 220 volt. 220 volt by what is resistance R? That is 50 ohm. 50 ohm. So this is equal to 0 cancel. That is equal to 22 by 5. So this is equal to 4.4 ampere. This is the current. 4.4 ampere. This is the flow of current. So next one, number 2 is number 2. Number 2. Calculate the resistance of a conductor. Calculate the resistance of a conductor calculate the resistance of a conductor if the current flowing through it if the current flowing through it if the current flowing through it is 0.2 ampere is 0.2 ampere is 0.2 ampere when the applied potential difference is when the applied potential difference is 0.8 volt. So this is the question. Now for solution, what is the solution? Solution, see here, we have to find out the resistance. R has been asked here. And then and current I is given here 0.2 ampere. I is equal to 0.2 ampere. And potential difference V is equal to 0.8 volt. We have the formula V is equal to IR. V is equal to IR. That means therefore R is equal to V by I. V by I. So this is equal to 0.8 by 0.2. So this is equal to 4 ohm. That is equal to 4 ohm. So this is the question. So here resistance has been asked. I is given here 0.2 ampere. B is given there 0.8 volt. So V is equal to IR is the formula. R is equal to V by I. So 0.8 by 0.2. As after decimal there are one places. So both the decimals are like decimals. So cut away and you will get a whole number 4 ohm. So next one is number 3. Number 3. We have a copper wire of resistance R. We have a copper wire of resistance R. Of resistance R. This wire is pulled so that this wire is pulled so that the length is doubled. Length is doubled. Length is doubled. Find the new resistance of the wire to its original resistance. Find the new resistance in terms of its original resistance, So see here, temperature is constant. So here what we have, we know that R is equal to rho L by A. When we pull the area of cross section, the area of cross section is halved because length is doubled. So area is halved. Because the wire is pulled. So new resistance is equal to R dash is equal to rho 2L by 1 by 2 A. So when here resistance will be, this is equal to rho 4L by A. So if we will see that rho 4L by A. So this is equal to, therefore R is equal to 4R is equal to R dash. That means the new resistance will be, four times the original resistance. See here, again I am explaining you this problem. This is an important problem. We have a certain material, copper wire, whose resistance is R. This wire is pulled so that the length is doubled. Find the new resistance. But remember, the wire is pulled. That means it is stretched. So when a wire, when a thing is stretched, if the length increases, then the area also decreases in the same proportionate. So R is equal to here L rho L by A. Here, but here what happens? The length is doubled. So in the same, inverse proportionate, area will decrease. So this one is doubled, so area will be half. Because it is stretched, so as the length increases, the area also decreases in the inverse proportionate. So it is 2 times, that means it is 1 by 2 times of the area. 1 by 2 times of the area means rho is equal to 4L by A. So see here, R is equal to rho L by A. And this one is equal to 4 into rho L by A. So 4R is equal to R dash. So the new resistance will be 4 times the original resistance. So with this, we will wait for the second, third part of the numerical problems. You all go through these problems. You will naturally be cleared about the numericals on the current electricity on these three formulas and some more formulas and some more problems we will discuss about the Ohm's law. But before that, now time is over. So go through the videos nicely. Go through the channel nicely and subscribe the channel and give your comments for the videos. And I will naturally 100% sure I will convey your comments and rectify my mistakes in the videos. And then your subscription will make the channel more powerful and your comments will make the videos more improvised so that you can get more knowledge. Okay, wait for the third part and we will very soon coming you with the third part in this channel. So for the other formulas by some more examples. I myself Kunal from Kunal's Horizon always request you to subscribe the channel to comment in the comment box. Thank you.